Hello, and welcome to the demo of Ingenious Pulse, where I will show you how to test and measure the health of your applications and infrastructure from anywhere. My name is Jason Chafee. I'm the Senior Product Manager for Ingenious Pulse. Today, I'm going to give you one quick slide to just give you an overview of Ingenious Pulse, kind of talk about how it works and why we built it. And then I'm going to go through a couple of example use cases, showing you the different things you can use within the system. First one being where customers and users are having problems accessing Office 365 from a Phoenix location. And then secondly, I'm going to highlight our business transaction test, which is a BTT to Salesforce.com. So I usually like to start talking about why we built Ingenious Pulse. So if you think about customers that have remote locations, whether those are branch offices or warehouses or distribution centers, or really in today's pandemic world, all these work from home users that we have, but it doesn't even need to be carpeted areas. These could be, we have customers who actually put them in cell towers and on ships and on forklifts, but it's really where you need the ability to get and understand business connectivity to services and apps and the infrastructure that are running at all of those different sites. So what is Ingenious Pulse? So Ingenious Pulse is an active synthetic-based testing solution that emulates the user experience from all of those locations. So what does that mean? Well, that means that every 2 minutes, every 5 minutes, every whatever you want, you can act like a user from each and every one of these locations, whether someone's on the system or not, and really understand the availability and performances of the services and the perspective that these users are actually receiving. I usually start over on this kind of the wheel slide, I call it, on the right-hand side. And these are just examples of all the types of services and tests you can do with Ingenious Pulse. So starting off, you can do web services. So anything that's an internal application, like maybe Oracle or your intranet or your SaaS services, your external services, Office 365, Salesforce, Workday, whatever those applications may be, really, again, understanding that user experience, even though you don't own that infrastructure. You can also test VoIP phone calls. So make sure that the phone calls are up and running, that everyone can hear and you can actually speak clearly and be able to make those phone calls. Do things like network SLA. So test bandwidth, loss, latency, jitter, maybe between all of your locations or between your locations back to the data center. And then even test Wi-Fi. And if you think about Wi-Fi testing, you really need instrumentation. You just got to be there. So that's the ability to say and understand whether you can access all of these different services over both your wired and your wireless network. We can even do things like look at your ISP and path. So especially in a work from home environment, it's really important to help and understand whether this is an ISP problem or actually a network problem within your corporate environment. And then lastly, we tie this all back together and correlate the infrastructure health. So understanding whether your servers, routers, switches, VMware, Wi-Fi infrastructure, if any of that is actually affecting the services that your users are trying to use. So how do we do this? We do this with what we call endpoints, and we have two different flavors of that. There's a hardware endpoint, the endpoint 3000. And the idea of this is you can just go plug it into any location, put it in the technical closet, stick it under a desk, and really just leave it there and let it run its tests all the way through. And then, of course, there's also a software version, which we call a virtual endpoint. This is effective where you can put this on a server or a laptop, and especially the work from home users, you could put this on a user's workstation and, again, really understand what's happening from there. So let's look at a couple of use cases within Ingenious Pulse itself and understand some of the different things that you can do within this system to help solve these problems. So as we get into this, this is actually Ingenious Pulse. And as we're looking at the system, as we go across this, this is really meant to be a very simple red, yellow, green dashboard. So from all of your different locations where you're actually running services or testing infrastructure, do I have anything that's causing me a problem? And of course, from there, then you drill down into it to see exactly what's going on. So I mentioned in the use case that we're going to go over, we're going to see that we're having complaints. We're hearing problems from Phoenix. People are having problems accessing Office 365. So again, we see yellow here in Phoenix. So there's something going on. We can just click on the Phoenix location. And as we drill into Phoenix, we can start to see exactly what's happening and why we're having these issues. Now, in this case, you might typically have one or two endpoints at all of your locations. But in Phoenix, we happen to have put six in here because we really want to understand the user experience from all the different locations within that building. So these are all the endpoints across the top. And then down the left-hand side are the different services that we're monitoring. In this case, we're monitoring Office 365. And it's pretty easy right away to see that all of our wireless tests are showing orange or yellow, whereas our wired tests are actually showing green. So a pretty good indication, maybe this has something to do with our wireless network. But let's go ahead and click into the executive office's endpoint to get more details about what's going on. So for each one of these tests, we can see that they're 100% available. So everybody can get to them from each of these tests, whether it's wired or wireless. But again, our wireless tests are showing more of an orange kind of degraded state, whereas our wired green look like they're doing okay. So we can click into the performance tab. And on this performance tab, this is going to show all of the different tests that are being run from that endpoint at that location. One of the things we're doing here is we're actually doing a wireless and wired network latency comparison test. So as you go across, every time that this runs, we can see we've really got a lot of latency happening on the wireless network. Again, another strong indication, this probably has something to do with the Wi-Fi and not the application itself. But more specifically, as we look at the Office 365 test that we're testing simultaneously over both the wired and the wireless networks, as I mentioned before, every time this runs, and I'll say this a bunch of times, but it's every 2 minutes, every 5 minutes, every whatever you want, we're going to be measuring the DNS, network, SSL, client, application, and server. And when we look at the wired test, we go across and everything looks like it's actually only taking half a second to maybe a second and a half. So things are probably okay from the wired network perspective. However, on our wireless test, we see this big purple section. That indicates and shows that there's something to do with the network. But again, this is not a DNS issue. This is not a client issue, not even really an application issue. So the next step then is to click into the test log. As we go into the test log, really all this is a listing of all of the different tests. So every time that it runs, it's listing them all down. Again, we see the big network delay here. Everything seems to be caused by a network. But what, again, is really neat about Ingenious Pulse is we can now correlate that with the infrastructure for these tests. So if we click on this little green icon, we actually can see the vitals of the Wi-Fi. So understanding and seeing exactly where these tests are being run over the Wi-Fi network. So we can see things like which Wi-Fi network it's on, which BSSID, and even down to the access point and radio. And really one step further, we can click onto the radio here. And this is going to be where we're actually pulling the Wi-Fi controller to get stats of the Wi-Fi network itself. So in this case, we happen to be looking at it and we see we've got really high channel utilization happening on this AP and specifically on this radio. And really that's what in the end is causing your delays on the Office 365 for your executive office. And now, you know, it took me a couple of minutes to talk through all of that, but in reality, it's really a couple of clicks, maybe 30 seconds to a minute. You've drilled down to understand the root cause and see exactly what's causing these problems. So let's go ahead and look at another use case real quickly and look at how we can do this, look at other types of tests. So this is what we call our business services overview dashboard. And again, this is really meant to be a place where you can see and understand all of the different types of services that you're running from all of your different locations. So you can see all of your endpoints from all of your different sites. These happen to be NetScout offices around the world. And then all of the different services that you're running down the left-hand side. So it gives you a real chance to see the scope and impact of the tests that you're running. But as I said, we're hearing complaints that Salesforce is running slow. And as all of you know, it's probably people complaining at Salesforce. Well, then it must be the network. So you want the ability to drill in and understand whether this is in fact the network or something else. So we click into the Salesforce test. And it's really the same paradigm across all of the different types of tests. So it's very easy to understand and see what's going on. In this case, we have two different tests that we're running. The first one is the Salesforce login page. So this is the ability to really just kind of go knock on the front door of salesforce.com and understand what's my performance and availability. Can I get to this website and how long does it take to get there? So here we see, again, 100% available across all the sites, and it's taking 2 to 3 seconds to get there from each site. And if we go again to the performance tab, we'll see that same exact breakdown of DNS, network, SSL, client, application, and server. And again, as we go all the way down, we see it literally is pretty good just getting to this website. So you can be pretty confident right off the bat that this is not a network problem. This doesn't have anything to do with your infrastructure, your network, and you need to really be able to exonerate that. So if we go back then, this is where the example of the business transaction test or the BTT comes into play. So what we're doing here is we're actually stepping through a given website, whatever that site might be, with a script, and whether users are on the system or not, stepping through that site and understanding the application and how it's performing. Again, 100% availability, and we also see it's taking 30 to 29 seconds on the long times, and then only about 14 or 15 seconds where we see it's completely green. Once again, click on the performance tab and go into C. So this is an example of where this BTT is actually running. So what is it doing? It's going in, and again, I said this every time, every 2 minutes, every 5 minutes, every 8 minutes, every whatever you want, it's going in and logging in, going to an account, selecting opportunities, selecting a report, exporting a report, and logging back out. And again, as we see this breakdown, we see this big pink section, which is indicating that export is taking a long time. And this seems to be the case across all of these sites that have been slow. If we scroll back down, we don't see that in these other ones. So now what we've really understood is that this is actually not a network problem. This has nothing, again, to do with your network, but is really an application problem. So you have the evidence to go say, hey, application person, we've got a problem here. Or more importantly, or be able to go back to Salesforce themselves and say that you've got a problem with the export and be able to get that fixed as you go through that. So these are just a couple of quick examples to show you some of the things you can do within InGenius Pulse and understanding all of the different ways you can see those from all of your different locations and sites. So I want to thank you for your time. If you have any questions or want to know more about it, you can obviously contact me, or you can go to netscout.com/InGenius Pulse, or to schedule a live demo, please contact your sales representative. Thanks so much for your time.